Welcome back to OneStopTutorials.com. It's me, Alibaba, back again. How you doing, everyone? Now, in the last tutorial, we got our library elements in. I added one more library element to this section. I was thinking about this section, but this is probably going to only be on the home page, so I don't really need to worry about it because it's just as easy coming in and editing this in the home page as it is coming in and editing it inside of the actual library. Okay, so this is what I have done, okay? Now, we need to carry on moving forward, and I just need to check this through one more thing, and then we're going to start joining some of the Google tools and start using them to help us find out who's coming to our website and where they're coming from and stuff like that. So, what you need to do is, now you've actually added your library elements, you'll notice that in the side here, you have a folder called Library, and inside of there, you have your three links inside of there called Books, Bottom Links, and Left Nav, or whatever you've called them, okay? What you want to do is you want to make sure you actually upload those as well. So I'm going to go to my FTP and I'm going to drag those. I've actually done it already, but let me just show you what you got to do. You got to grab the library, grab everything that's in here except for the template and upload it one more time. I'm actually going to just upload these two, just going to upload them, but make sure your library is up there because that's what makes everything work. Okay, now what I want you to do is go to it's called browserlab.adobe.com. This is a really powerful tool to be able to see our website in multiple browsers. Okay, even though we've run a browser compatibility through Dreamweaver, we still want to make sure that actually everything is okay in all browsers. So simply go to that page. Once you get there, if you don't actually a member of this, it's free to join. Just simply join first. So try Browser Lab. Just simply join. And it'll just fill out the form. It's like a basic form, and then you'll be able to log in. So once you log in, you go to sign in, and then you just stick in your username and password. Now, it's not the fastest of programs in the world, but it's certainly going to actually show us what we need. I'm going to go to the test one here, the test button, and what I do is I'm going to stick that link in that I uploaded all my files to in my FTP, okay, which is onestoptutorials.com/recipes/index.html. I'm simply going to paste that in, and I'm going to click here to get it all working. Now, I like to have open view, two up view. Okay, what this will do is it'll allow me to see two different browsers in each section, so I could be able to view it in Firefox on the left. I'll be able to view it in Internet Explorer on the right. Okay, so I'm just going to pause it for time being because this takes a little bit of time because I live in Thailand internet. So I'll be back in a sec, guys and girls. Okay, so far I've got Firefox and Chrome up, okay, and what you do is you use these arrows here and you can choose the actual browser you want, Internet Explorer 8, 7, 6, Firefox, Chrome, Safari, okay, so at the moment some of them are still loading, but I just want to show you what it looks like. This is Firefox 2.0, and I'm going to make this Firefox 3.6, and what we do is we just check everything is sort of like in position, looking good, looking how we want it, okay, there's our links. And this is absolutely a powerful tool. I mean, you can check your website in multiple browsers by using this tool. It's an absolutely awesome tool. Okay, let's actually, what you can do now is we've got Firefox 2 here. Let's compare that to Chrome. Let's have a look what it looks like in Chrome. Again, it's all looking good. It might change a little bit. Things might look a little bit different, but everything's in place. Everything is aligned. This box isn't mental. It isn't out of the place, okay? Let's carry on looking through some other browsers. I guarantee that the browser that will cause you the most issue will be Internet Explorer 6. So here's Internet Explorer 6. Let's have a look how we're looking. And as you can see, we're actually getting a problem in Internet Explorer 6. Okay, now this problem I would imagine, or actually know, is something to do with the hack that we put in earlier. Okay, let me show you what I mean. If we come back and go back to our code view, you'll notice that we put this hack in, okay? Now, the area that's getting the problem is this area here. This area here is the cake content area, okay? You got the cake content, and then you got the P. So what we could try doing is as we know it's an ID, and it's called cake content, I could come back up to this hack, and I could stick that here, okay? So I could do a hash sign, it's called cake underscore content, okay, P. That's the, I'm actually homing in on the exact problem area, okay? So what I'm going to do is going to control S that. I'm then going to quickly upload that page again to see how we're getting on. Where is it? Index. Okay, if this is all you have to do, I mean, some of these areas I actually know what the problems are, but if you're not sure what the problems are, just send me an email or go to the Adobe section that I showed you before, and it will actually tell you maybe what's going on. So let's come back into Adobe Browser and let's do a refresh, and I think it's actually still loading. I think we got to wait. Okay, everything looks like it's okay. Okay, I'm going to click in here, and can I hit enter? Why won't it let me? Okay, it's going to do it again. So it's going to refresh it again, and remembering we had that problem in Internet Explorer 6, we'll wait and see if this has fixed the problem, and hopefully it has. Okay, and I'm just going to have a quick look as we've changed stuff. I've got Safari 4.0 on the left. I've got Chrome 3.0 on the right. I'm just making sure that since we changed that hack, it actually hasn't changed it to any of the other ones, messed it all up, made it look really bad. Nope, everything's looking good. The AdSense at the top. Yep, the button's in. Okay, and let's have a look at, still waiting for it to load. Let's have a look at Internet Explorer 8 because that one's done. Everything looks good. The text is wrapped around okay, so the hack hasn't messed up Internet Explorer 8. This is really good practice to get into, is checking your pages in a tool like this, especially Browser Lab, because Browser Lab is so powerful that you can view it in so many different browsers. It's really, really good to get into the habit of actually doing this. Internet Explorer 6, we're still waiting. There it is, it's come through now. Let me click on Internet Explorer 6, and as you can see, hopefully the text is wrapped around fine. So everything is pretty much looking good. We're in Internet Explorer 8, we're in Internet Explorer 6. We could wait for Internet Explorer 7, but generally if it's okay in 8 and 6, it means it will be okay in 7. So watch out for Internet Explorer 6, guys and girls. That is one of the browsers, and people still do use it. People are still using Internet Explorer 6. They don't think, well, it's an old browser, nobody's using it. They do, so it's a good idea to get into building web design that it suits as many browsers as it possibly can, so it actually shows up in all browsers. So we've done great. First, we did a browser compatibility in Dreamweaver, so we checked that everything was okay with that. We then validated our CSS and we validated our HTML to check our code is 100% clean. Everything was okay. We then come to a tool like Browser Lab, which allowed us to check it in multiple browsers, and everything is okay. This is the way to build website. Get in the habit. I know it seems long-winded, and I know it's like, well, you know, I want to build my next page, but what's the point in building your next page and your next page and your next page if your first page isn't correct? Well, you know, you're going to be duplicating your errors on multiple pages. This, in the long run, even though it seems to take a little bit longer, is the best way to build websites, because you can now safely know that your website is clean. Your website, doesn't matter what browser your customer's using, your website's going to look good. You don't have to worry about any of the problems because you've been through these simple stages of making everything look good, and it's going to save you so much time and effort. Trust me, since I started getting into this discipline of building websites this way, websites become a lot easier and you look more respectable when errors and stuff aren't being shown. So in the next tutorial, we're going to come into some Google tools. We're going to start with Google Analytics. We're going to set up a new account. We're going to have to set up a new email address, or you can use your email address if you've got one. I've already set one up under my email address, so I'm going to open up a new email address. We're going to do Google Analytics, because Google Analytics is going to give us a code that we're going to add to our pages, and we'll be able to track every page on who's coming to that page, how long they're on that page, and things like that. So take it easy, guys and girls. Be back very soon. Please do not forget to send me your links of all the work that you've done. I'm doing a video on the 10th of August. I want to promote you guys and girls for free. So send me your links. Send me your work. Whatever you've done via one-stop tutorials, send it to me, and I will promote you guys and girls for free. Take it easy, everyone. Catch you at the next one-stop tutorials.